Hi, I'm Matthew Coast, head dating coach and founder at CommitmentConnection.com. And in this video, we're going to talk about who you should be with. So be with someone who does these 8 things for you. What are they? Find out in this video. If this is your first time to our channel, make sure that you hit the subscribe button to get more videos on how to have the relationship that you've always wanted. So what are must-haves in a relationship? What things should you strive to make sure that you're experiencing when you're looking at a guy and you're saying, is this the right guy for me? What should you be looking at? I think you should have your own list, but I also have a few things here that I think are really important that you should think about and that you should really look at as things that are important for you to have in a relationship. So thing number one that you want to have that a guy does is have a guy who pays attention to you, right? So a guy that listens to you, a guy that takes in consideration your needs, what you want, what's going on with you, and really listens and pays attention to what's going on with you and is not just all about himself. So thing number two that you want to look for is a guy who puts in the effort, right? Who puts in, who does the little things, who invests in you, you know, a guy that does things for you, that goes out of his way and will put other things aside in order to help you, in order to make you feel happy, in order to be with you and spend time with you, in order to make sure that you experience love and are feeling loved. A guy that puts in the effort, you want to have that. That's actually one of the most important things that I believe that you should be looking for in a guy, is a guy that puts in who does the little things and puts in that effort for those little things to make sure that you're having a great relationship. So the third thing that I think you should look for in a guy that you're in a relationship with is a guy who supports you and believes in you and supports whatever it is that you choose to do with your life. And so you'll meet lots of guys out there that are, good-looking guys and that have a lot of good things going on. But do they care about, you being happy and you doing things that make you happy and give you a fulfilling life and let you experience joy? And do they support you in the things that you want to do and what you want to create? And whatever your heart desires, do they accept that in who you are and support you in doing it? So thing number four that you should be watching out for with a man is you want to find a guy who's really kind to your family, right? Who treats not only you right, but treats your family right, who's good to them, who is kind to them, who's good to your siblings if you have siblings, who's good to your parents if you have parents. You want to find a man who's kind at heart and treats people well, and the best place to look at that, there's a bunch of different places you can look at that, and I think one of the most important places is in your family, right? And how he treats your family and what he does around your family and how he looks at them and how he communicates with them and how he interacts with them. So thing number five that I think you should look for, be with a man who does this is a guy who is willing to enjoy life no matter what goes on, right? And it's one of those ideas like amor fati, right? Which is like just the love of fate, right? Like who can experience and enjoy life no matter where you are, no matter what's going on, no matter what you're doing. I'm not saying that he has to be happy all the time, right? Like nobody's happy all the time, and if you are, it's probably some kind of fake weird thing that you're trying to force or pretend. Having the ability to enjoy yourself and each other no matter what you're doing. One of the things I talk about, like going on dates with guys, is it's going to be, that it's good if you guys can just hang out and go do anything together, right? If you have to go and do something when you go on a date, it's going to be a problem because it's like, There's going to be a lot of downtime in a relationship, and you need to be able to just hang out and spend time and enjoy each other no matter where you are, no matter what you're doing, no matter, what kind of circumstances you're in. If you have a guy that like gets really kind of uptight and down about things, and he can't seem to enjoy himself in multiple different types of situations, that could be a problem for the welfare and the happiness of your relationship. So thing number six that you should be looking for is a guy who can handle disagreements in a mature way. So this guy, every relationship's going to have disagreements, right? And if your relationship doesn't have disagreements, that's a red flag, because it means that either you or he is avoiding something, right? And it's probably going to blow up at some point. I've seen this multiple times in many different situations. I've seen divorces where couples were like, oh yeah, everything's going great, and then all of a sudden it exploded and they get divorced. There's going to be conflict, right? There's going to be disagreements. There's going to be things that happen in your relationship. And, you know, the question is, how do you guys treat it? Do you treat it like it's the end of the world? Does he treat it like, like all of a sudden he's going to be resentful or revengeful towards you? You want a guy who comes at it in a mature way and says, you know, maybe we disagree on this, but I still care about you. I still love you. We're still together on this, or we're still together regardless of having a disagreement right here. And that's really what you want to look for. So thing number seven is look for a man who's willing to be a provider, right? Who's willing to take kind of that masculine role on, you know? And I know there's some relationships that work out really well with the guy being the feminine and the woman being the masculine role. But in general, I think that it's a really powerful place for a man to be. I think most women out there, most women at least in our community, and most men that I used to coach, most men wanted feminine women and they wanted to be the masculine guy. Most of the women that I talk to want to be the feminine force and have a masculine guy. And so if you want that masculine man, make sure that you're with a man who's willing to provide, who's willing to protect, who's willing to be willing to take charge and step up and make sure that things are going okay, make sure that everything's all right, that he's willing to take care of things, right? Like that's a mature, responsible man. So thing number eight is that I think that you should be with someone who's emotionally mature, right? Someone who is willing to go into their emotions, a man that's willing to go into their emotions and, isn't afraid of their emotions, right? There's a lot of men and women out there that are afraid of their emotions. And I think that the healthiest people and the healthiest relationships are relationships where people are, they feel free to express their emotions. They feel free to open up. They feel free to challenge themselves in areas where they feel pain, right? And a lot of relationships that end up failing are relationships where there's these kind of emotional barriers that they're not allowed to get into or they aren't willing to get into. And it can end up being really destructive for the relationship. So that's the eight things. What's your list? What things do you think are incredibly important to have in a man? Make sure you leave a comment below about that and tell us what do you think about this? Thanks for watching this video. If you're ready to know exactly what to say and do to attract the man and the relationship you've always wanted, click on the button on the right-hand side of this video and go to our website.